The handing over of the water well was appreciated by residents of SONGO and its immediate environs, taking into consideration the present water shortage in the western area. According to the Minister of Political and Public Affairs, Nanette Thomas, government is concerned about the water shortage and that plans have been put in place to urgently address water shortage. She described the handing over of the water well as a timely intervention, which she said is geared towards addressing the water problem in the SONGO community. Mrs. Thomas appealed to beneficiaries to take good care of the well as it is a community property and commended the Chief Executive Officer of EnviroOne Sustainable Development Project for the initiative.
I take this honor and pleasure for first hand over to the Honorable Minister. We go hand over to the town.
I take the singular honor for la hand over the keys to the community.
Yes, Mr. Edman.
The Chief Executive Officer of EnviroOne Sustainable Development Project, Dr. David Kargbo, gave a brief profile of the project, noting that similar water well has been dug in other communities. He maintained that SONGO is located in a strategic area but has been neglected in terms of community development. Dr. Kargbo informed residents in SONGO of plans to construct another water well for them and stressed the need for proper maintenance of the well.
Hopefully this water well here go help for begin for solve that problem there. We do hope say, in addition to this water well, because the tongue big and this alone not be enough, we will hope say we will be able to get another one. We will locate now a place where we will now be able for address and help all the people in SONGO.
Residents of SONGO thank the Chief Executive Officer of EnviroOne for the laudable venture and appeal for more support in the area of education, agriculture and microfinancing. The handing over of this water well will, among other development issues, address the problem of residents who travel almost half a mile to fetch water from unprotected streams. SABC News, Joseph Stanley reporting.